how are we going to communicate this? We don't want to carry around a mouse, right? So what are we going to do? Oh, a stylus, right? We're going to use a stylus. No. No. Who wants a stylus? You have to get them and put them away and you lose them. Yuck.
All around me are familiar faces, worn out places, worn out faces.
Hey guys, it's time to compare the granddaddy of the granddaddy itself, the Galaxy Note phone, against the Galaxy Note 8. A difference of 6 years. Just how far Samsung has come in terms of design, camera, display. We're gonna compare everything. The Galaxy Note was a commercial success for Samsung. It was released in October of 2011, and by the end of the year, Samsung was able to sell over 1 million units, and they released a LTE version of this phone, and after that, they collectively sold about 10 million units worldwide. The Galaxy Note literally gave birth to a phablet name. I still remember how people reacted to this phone when it first came out, like 5.3 inch is too big, and now 5.3 inch is not even a size for main phones. Most of the phones are coming from 5.5 inch and all the way to 6 inches. So the original Note has a 5.3 inch display and the Note 8 has a 6.3 inch display. Note 8 is taller while the Galaxy Note is wider. It's not just the screen, the display resolution and the quality of the actual colors and everything has improved a lot. According to DisplayMate, this is the best display that they have ever tested on a smartphone. Without a doubt, right now, the Note 8 is the best smartphone display on the market. Samsung has always been the best when it comes to the screen resolution and the screen bezels. This original Note from 6 years ago still has a better screen-to-body ratio than the iPhone 7 Plus. The iPhone freaking 7 Plus, the best iPhone that Apple offers at the moment. It will get replaced by the iPhone 8 pretty soon, but it is absolutely crazy to think that the original Note phone from 2011 has a better screen to body ratio and less bezels than Apple's best smartphone right now. And as far as the colors and everything goes, it's still a pretty good display. But of course, Samsung has achieved new heights with the Galaxy Note 8. Now, if you look at these two phones side by side, you can't really say that the Note is like an ancestor to this phone. I mean, this design that Samsung debuted with the original Note phone continued for a long time. The Galaxy Note 2, Note 3, Note 4, Note 5, Note FE, even the Note FE, I mean. You compare the Galaxy Note to these phones, you can say, yeah, I mean, they are somewhat related. But when you compare it to the Galaxy Note 8, it's different. Because with the Note 8, it's the end of an era. There is no home button. Samsung has gone to infinity. And from now on, you will always see Samsung flagship phone with this beautiful infinity display. Maybe 6 years from now with Note 15, we might see a foldable 7.4-inch display, who knows, but this infinity design is here to take the crown for a long time. Now, as far as the design goes, Samsung went from a cheap plasticky phone to a full-on premium phone. Now, of course, with plastic, we had this ability to remove the back, which allowed us to change the battery as well as play with the SIM card and the micro SD card. But nowadays, this stuff doesn't matter, I mean, to most of the mainstream audience. Samsung took the right decision and listened to the customers by making their phones super premium. It started with the Note 5, and now we have the super premium Galaxy Note 8. The original Note had no security feature, like, of course, there was no fingerprint scanner back in those days. Now the Galaxy Note 8 not only has a fingerprint scanner but also has an iris scanner and a facial scanner. As far as the software goes, we have seen a huge change with the Samsung's Experience UI, which was previously called as Gray Stitches UI, which first came with the Galaxy Note 7. I mean, it's not recognizable, but still you can see the elements, the core TouchWiz thing is still there, like we have this weather widget and then the Google thing going on, single app row and then a dock. TouchWiz lag was a real problem back in the days. Whenever people used to hear the word TouchWiz, they automatically relate it with lag. So I guess that's why Samsung changed the name from TouchWiz to Samsung Experience UI. But what Samsung really did is that they basically made their UI more easier to operate. You can see there's the option of app and widget here at the home screen. And you can see the same widget option in the app drawer as well. This was a huge problem. You will see things over and over again and Samsung fixed that. Now you don't get the widget option in the app drawer. Instead, it's just present at the home screen. And of course, there was no theme engine back in the day, so Samsung also introduced that to customize your phone without installing any custom launcher or rooting your phone. You can see the notification panel, like everything is just in front of you. You don't have to swipe all the way to the right, and it has more options and allows you to customize, which I don't think you can do on the Note. And also a huge change to the settings as well. Now you have all the options with the description at the bottom, which basically makes the experience a lot more easier. My Galaxy Note has a faulty battery, so I have to connect it to the charger. But if we talk about the performance, that has improved a lot as well. Like opening up of simple basic applications, that is so much faster nowadays. Settings, calculator. I mean, this is still a usable phone. It's not terrible, but I'm glad we have improved really well when it comes to processing power. Now, as far as the S Pen goes, Samsung has improved this as well. Like you can see, it's more premium, just like the phone itself. They also improved the tip of the S Pen. So the original S Pen of the Galaxy Note feels a bit plasticky. I mean, it works perfectly on the Note 8, but it has this plasticky feeling, while the new S Pen has this more of a premium rubber feeling when you touch the display. Just like the Galaxy Note 8, this S Pen also works absolutely perfect on the original Note. And of course, if you're an artist, you will definitely feel much better with the newer S Pen, because at a certain angle, this doesn't work. While the new one works flawlessly, whether you are drawing like this or this, it always gets the action done, so you don't miss the part while coloring or drawing in general. So the S Pen is now premium as well as more accurate. Now the next area where Samsung really excelled over the years is the camera. It's just so insane to see how far we have come from this to this. Like this picture, I captured it in a fairly dark environment. It was evening time, but you can see how much detail and quality of information you can get in the Galaxy Note 8. The details are just insane. There can be as good as professional cameras. And of course, with awesome camera comes the awesome software. The Galaxy Note 8, you get live focus mode, which basically allows you to blur the background, making the picture look like it's captured from a DSLR. And the result is just absolutely insane. Like 6 years ago, if I showed you this picture and said that I captured it on a smartphone, you probably wouldn't believe me. The new Note 8 is also water and dust resistant. It has fast charging, it has wireless charging, and after all these years, it still has the headphone jack. So yeah, guys, we have come a long way, and we definitely deserve the best of the best. 2017 is awesome, and 2018 will be even more awesome. It's really crazy what Samsung has achieved over the years and how tech has progressed in our lives. Not only we have better phones, but also better software and better applications to take advantage of this awesome hardware. If you guys enjoyed this video, please slap a like, and why not subscribe to the channel for future content? And I will see you guys in the next one. Peace out.